We're talking with Jason Christiansen, the CEO and owner of Internet Media, on the topic of internet and real estate. I went to one of your seminars and I heard you say that wherever you go across the country, you find that a tremendous amount of real estate agents are using the internet to their advantage, with the exception of the real estate agents you're seeing in Colorado. Why do you think that is?
Well, I think with that, it's really the understanding of realtors here are using internet technology, but they're not getting properly trained on real estate technology. And I mentioned that in my class because I believe there was a foreclosure class that was just a few days prior, and there was 150 people at that class.
Right.
And there was only about 20 or 30 realtors at an internet technology class, and I kind of find that interesting that they don't come to get trained on how to use the future of real estate.
My grandmother didn't like technology. I mean, every time I go over to the house, the clock was still flashing 12. She was just afraid of technology. I mean, do you think that's the reason that most real estate agents just don't get more involved in the web?
Absolutely. I look at it as realtors need training wheels out there. They need a real estate coach. They need someone to show them the proven ways of how to use the internet. And the internet is so simple. But if they put little steps and little automated processes in, then they won't have to be afraid of it, and then they'll really get the benefit and actually save time and make more money.
Well, see, I can hear the argument already, though. You know, I barely have enough time in my day already to handle my buyers, my sellers, my marketing, my contracts. Where am I going to get time to essentially run a business on the internet?
Yeah, that's a great question, and I hear that every day. And I really break that down too, is I believe every realtor can find 15 extra minutes a day to really put forth and start adding these pieces of automation into their business. And if you did that every day for over the course of a year, you will have a tremendous amount of clients added to your automated systems, and that's going to really benefit you long term.
Hmm. Now, some people have taken what you said, they believe it wholeheartedly, and they put up a site and they leave it there. They mm-hmm. think that's all they have to do is put up a site and people are just going to naturally come to it. I think they're unaware of what it really takes to generate traffic to that site.
Absolutely. That's what I call the billboard in the middle of the desert approach. And basically, you put it up and they will come, and that is not the case. You have to have a proper internet strategy, for one, and two, a marketing strategy based around your website. So if you know how to market your website and you have the proper technology, then you will be able to create a massive traffic jam to your website.
What about blogging? We hear a lot about blogging. We hear it's the future as far as, you know, having active content that's constantly changing on your website to make your website relevant out there to all the search mm-hmm. engines and so forth. Tell me about blogging.
Well, blogging is a very interesting thing because like what you just said is people don't have time to work on their websites, and blogging does take a lot of time. If you can blog efficiently, you're going to blog 3 days a week, and you want to make it very interesting. But what a blog is, it's a journal in reverse chronological order about something out there. Now, most realtors believe that a blog needs to be about the real estate industry, but the most successful real estate blogs that I've seen are about stuff that they're really passionate about, such as football or horse properties or other things like that. But if you're passionate about it, you'll be able to go in and spend a little bit more time doing it.
Gotcha. So do you recommend it for your agents?
I really recommend it for the people that can take the time to add the blog. If you can't spend the time, though, to write a blog, then I don't recommend doing the blog because you're going to only have a few entries and you're not going to create this traffic on your blog.
Now, I know you're a big fan of video coming on the web and you think it's really the new frontier in what's happening with web technology and specifically real estate, but where can that video take us? What's it going to do for us?
Well, if you look at the cross between newspapers and television and basically how even advertisers are moving all online, rich media advertising is kind of how I look at video advertising, is you can do videos for virtual tours, you can do videos for just interviewing people and telling people about yourself. There are so many aspects that you can use video that will really benefit your business, and what I like about it is it's a really duplication of yourself. So you can duplicate yourself so you are really available 24/7 to be there in person.
Jason, thanks so much for
talking
with us.
Thank you, Dan.
We appreciate it.
Thank you very much.
Find more real estate videos at BrokerIPTV.com.